الحمد لله رب العالمين. إن شاء الله we'll continue with the تفسير of جزء عامة based on the summarized تفسير of سيدنا ابن كثير. We reached to the end of سورة المطففين yesterday. Inshallah, if you want to check the earlier sessions, you can go back to the sessions from the beginning of the month of this tafsir. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد مدد أولياء الله عينونا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله. And we reach اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد سورة الانشقاق. إذا السماء واستعيذ بالله إذا السماء انشقت وأذنت لربها وحقت وإذا الأرض مدت وألقت ما فيها وتخلت وأذنت لربها وحقت يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا وينقلب إلى أهله مسرورا وأما من أوتي كتابه وراء ظهره فسوف يدعو ثبورا ويصلى سعيرا إنه كان في أهله مسرورا إنه ظن أن لن يحور بلى إن ربه كان به بصيرا إذا السماء انشقت. This refers to the day of judgment when the heavens will split asunder. وأذنت لربها وحقت and obeyed and listened to its Lord means the heavens. وحقت as it must do. It's Allah's right on all creation to obey. وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ مُدَّتْ and if the earth is expanded and stretched. وَأَلْقَتْ مَا فِيهَا وَتَخَلَّتْ and it spit out whatever is in it. All the graves of the deceased will open and people will be resurrected. وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ in obedience to its Lord as it must. يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. Oh human being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing us. Verily, oh human being, you are working hard but you are on your way returning to your Lord. No matter what you do, you are moving towards that appointment. إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا means you are moving towards the appointed date where you return to your Lord. فَمُلَاقِي you are going to be in your Lord's presence. You are rushing. Whatever you're doing, you are carrying with you and moving towards your Lord. And here the Mufassir quotes the hadith of Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam says, Ya Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, عِشْ مَا شِئْتَ live as long as you like, فَإِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ at the end, you will die. وَأَحْبِبْ مَا شِئْتَ وَأَحْبِبْ مَنْ شِئْتَ and love whomever you like. Be attached to whomever you like. فَإِنَّكَ مُفَارِقُ you will reach, you will have to separate from your beloved. No way out of it. وَأَعْمَلْ مَا شِئْتَ and do whatever you like. فَإِنَّكَ مُلَاقِي do whatever you like, gather of deeds, whatever you like, at the end you will bring your deeds and meet your Lord. يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا. Verily, you are gathering your deeds and running, rushing to your Lord to meet Him, knowingly or unknowingly, believing or not believing. All of us like a river moving towards that appointed time when we leave this world, when we die, when we are resurrected. We are all moving towards that. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِ. Whoever is given his book of deeds in his right hand on judgment day, he is from the happy ones. If your book is handed to you in your right hand, you know you are from the successful ones. اللهم اجعلنا منهم يا رب يا رب. Grant us to be from the people who are handed their books in the right hand. فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا. And here, whoever is given his book in his right hand, his accounting will be very smooth, very easy. He will not be taken to task. When his deeds are looked into, he will not have a hard time. And here the author mentions a hadith that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Sayyida Aisha, Ya Aisha, man nuqisha al-hisab, udhib. O Aisha, whoever is called for an audit, yani if on judgment day your name comes for audit, like here now for those people living in the West, how stressed they will be if Canada Revenue or the IRS in the United States calls you for an audit. You'll be worried and stressed that they may find something, make you pay a lot of money, or even worse, that you are doing. Well, on judgment day, Prophet ﷺ said to Sayyida Aisha, Ya Aisha, man nuqisha al-hisab a'udhib. Means if they call you to account and they open your books and say, what is this? How do you account for that? At that time, if that process starts, Prophet ﷺ said, pray that that process, that auditing does not begin. Hasab hisaban yasira means, just say, okay, Allah. Give you your book in your right hand and said, come through. But if they open the books and they start, what is this and what is that? من نوقش الحساب عذب. So Sayyida Aisha said to Prophet ﷺ, what about the verse that Allah, didn't Allah say, فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا, that they will be, whoever is given his book in his right hand, they will be the accounting will be very smooth, very easy. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, laysa dhalika bil hisab. He said that's not what is meant with accounting, ولكن ذلك العرض. من نوقش الحساب يوم القيامة عذب. She said that is the day when the deeds are displayed. That is the day of reckoning, when everybody's deeds will be presented and displayed. But whoever is called for interrogation, for auditing, Prophet ﷺ said, will receive some punishment. Allahumma afina. Ya Rab. So we hope to be from those who are not called to an audit or an account, to be entered with Allah's mercy, as we are asking in this holy month, that our deeds be forgiven completely, that we be from those whom Allah choose every day to guarantee safety from hellfire. If you are guaranteed safety from hellfire, and what accounting you are going to be accounted for? You already given certification. We want to be like that. فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا وينقلب إلى أهل مسرورا. So the people with books in the right hand, their books of deeds in the right hands, they will have an easy time, and they will go to their families happy. Means they will join their families in heaven happy. Happy and delight by what Allah has given them of delights in heaven. The opposite type of people, this is the one who are given the books in the right hand. What about the people who are given the books in the left hand? وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِ. And the ones who are given their books, yani the humiliation of these people is the books are not presented in their left hand, coming delivering it from facing them. Their hands, left hands, will be behind their back, and their books of deeds will be given from behind their back, وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِ, in their left hand. When these people receive their books of deeds in their left hand, and the realization that whatever the prophets brought of truth is real, and that judgment day is real, and that they have to account for their deeds, when that realization sets in, what will happen? فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا. At that time they will ask that they be nothing, they will be destroyed for destruction. They ask that their existence at that point ends. يَا لَيْتَنِي إِنْ سُورَةَ عَمَّ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا. No, what? اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. They wish that they are dust. They cease to exist. بَلَا إِنَّ رَبَّهُ كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا. إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ أَن لَّن يَحُورَ. That why, what made him reach this state? What made him reach this bad ending? To be standing in front in judgment day and with his book of deeds in his left hand, wishing that he didn't exist. What got him there is that he didn't believe. He didn't believe that he has to account for his deed. He didn't believe in judgment day. He didn't believe he will meet his Lord. He didn't believe that his deeds will be presented and he will have to account for everything. This is what got him to be there in the first place. إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ يَحُورَ. بَلَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, yes, now that he realizes, بَلَى, for sure, إِنَّ رَبَّهُ كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing him. Has ever been, he's under the observation of his Lord. بَلَا إِنَّ رَبَّهُ كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا. Allah did not forget him. Allah is observing him. Allah is watching over him. He was never on his own. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ. And here the verses go into qasam, means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by some of his great signs. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ. اللهم صلي على سيدنا محمد. I swear by الشَّفَق. Shafaq is the time between Maghrib and Isha when the sun, when you can still see some reddish in the horizon. That's the shafaq. Allah is swearing by shafaq. Wal-layli, and by the night time. Wama wasaq, and whatever is gathered in the light time, night time, of stars and animals and beings. والقمر إذا اتسق. سيدنا ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما said that when the moon comes together, that's one meaning. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, or maybe in reference to the fact that the moon was divided, or it could mean when the moon becomes full, as Sayyidina Qatada said, وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا اتَّسَقْ لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ. Verily, Allah is swearing that you will be traveling from one stage to another, from one form to another. You shall certainly move from one stage to another stage. لَتُرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ, or from one form to another form, or from one state to another state, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be moving you. It could mean when you were a baby, and then the stages of growing. It could also mean that you move from ease to difficulty, from health to sickness, and so forth. And it could also mean you move from one form of being to another. فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. How come they don't believe? What is it with them? What is wrong with them that the truth is shining like the sun and they don't accept? And when وَإِذَا قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقُرْآنَ, and when Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and when the Quran is recited for them, it does not make them awestruck. It does not touch their heart, and they don't go in sajda. فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ وَإِذَا قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقُرْآنُ لَا يَسْجُدُونَ. Here we have to make sajda tilawa. Whenever we recite these verses of tilawa, it is sunnah to make sajda. Allahu Akbar. وَإِذَا قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقُرْآنُ بَلِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يُكَذِّبُونَ. Allah says, verily, those who rejected, those who abstained, those who denied the truth, those who didn't accept, they are lying, they are liars. وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يُعُونَ. And Allah knows not just what they're saying or what they display. Allah knows what is contained within their hearts, what is within them, what is concealed in their chests. فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. So announce to them, inform them of the torments they will be experiencing, the painful torments that they will be experiencing. This is إِلَّا الَّذِينَ, except, excluded from this punishment, those who believe, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and performed good deeds, they have أجر, they have a reward that never ends, غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ. لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ means a never-ending reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until when Allah wants, their reward will continue. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Inshallah, we will continue. We still have a few 10 minutes. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim to Surah Al-Buruj in Juz' Amma. This is chapter 85. And like most of the surah of Juz' Amma, it was revealed in Mecca. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والسماء ذات البرود واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود. والسماء ذات البرود, Allah is swearing by the heavens and its constellations. Ibn Jarir, he said that it means the positions of the sun. Buruj is the positions of the sun as it moves, and the moon, which is the 12 months where it moves from in the sky. والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود, and by the promised day, the day of judgment, and by وشاهد ومشهود, and by the witness and that which he witnesses, that which he witnessed. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. Ibn Hatim recorded that Sayyidina Ibn Hurayra, Abu Hurayra رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, had said, واليوم الموعود, the allotted day is the judgment day, وشاهد is the day of Friday, and ومشهود is the day of Arafah in their tafsir. And Allah is swearing by these holy days, Judgment Day, Day of Friday, Day of Arafah, as a great signs. And here he mentions the hadith that on Friday, that the importance of Friday, that Friday there isn't a day, there isn't a day on which the sun rises and sets that is better than the day of Friday. And in it there is an hour, لا يوافقها عبد مسلم يسأل الله فيها خيرا إلا أعطاه إياه, that in Friday there's an hour that some say it is after Fajr, before Ishraq. Some ulama said it is after Jum'ah prayer. Some ulama said that that hour is right before Maghrib, or the hour before, between Asr and Maghrib. And that's why most turuq, they do their weekly dhikr on Fridays. They try to catch that hour. قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ, the people of the ditch were murdered, were killed. No, the people of the ditch, not referring to the people who were thrown in the fire. The people of the ditch are the people that dug a ditch and filled it with fire, and then they threw the believers in. So those people are cursed. قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ refers to them, that they are cursed people, the ones who, the story of the ditch. It is said that there was a king who had a magician, and the magician was old, and the king was an unbeliever. I'm just summarizing the story of the ditch, and we'll end with that, inshallah. That on, as the king started to get, was very old, he asked the king that I might not live long, so if you want to have a magician, you need to give me some, I can train, someone I can train. And the king gave him this boy, who was very smart, and he was learning with the magician. He, in the process, as he was learning, he at the same time met a monk, and that monk was a believing in Allah. And he mentioned one time Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and the boy asked him, what is that? And he had to tell him. And so the boy, short story, long story short, as they say, I'm just summarizing it, but the boy, the king finds out, and they killed the magician finds out, tells the king kills the monk, and he tries to kill the boy. He asks the boy about who is his lord, and he says, Allah is my lord. He wouldn't recant, so he tried to kill him by taking him on top of the mountain, and each time he tries to kill him three times, he sends him in a ship also, the boy lands from the mountain and is living, send him on a ship to be buried in the sea, and everybody else perishes, and the boy comes back. Finally, the boy tells the king, if you want to kill me, I can give you the secret, but you have to do it yourself. He said, okay. So what is the secret? He said, you can shoot me with an arrow, but it will not work. The arrow will not work unless you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And so the king gathered the people and he did this, and he said Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and shot the child with an arrow and killed him. When the people saw this, they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believed in what the monk was teaching and what this boy was saying. And when the king found out, he dug a ditch and threw these people, built a fire in the ditch, and he threw these people in the fire. That's why it is said, قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ, that the people of the ditch were cursed. النَّارِ ذَاتِ الْوَقُودِ, where flames and fire were fed with fuel in that ditch. And the people were put next to this hot fire before they threw them in. وَإِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُودٌ, إِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُودٌ, as the unbelievers who did this were sitting there watching as they were throwing the believers in. So they were witnesses themselves. وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ شُهُودٌ, they were witnessing on the evil they were committing against the believers. And the only وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَمِيدِ, they don't have anything against these people that will cause them to do this except one thing, that these people believed in Allah Al-Aziz Al-Hamid. We'll end with this inshallah, and tomorrow we will continue. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.